Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate. Look, last week I was in London, and I said in the last episode I would try to get an episode recorded, but it didn't work out. So this week we'll be covering a few of the big things that happened last week as well. That said, I did get a GitHub t-shirt, and as promised, I'm wearing it. All right, let's get into this week's latest dev news. First up, and this actually happened last week, Azure Kubernetes Service, aka AKS, has reached general availability and is also available in 5 new regions, including Australia East, UK South, West US, West US 2, and North Europe. AKS is Azure's managed Kubernetes service, and it's a great way for developers to manage their container-based solutions without having to have a lot of Kubernetes expertise. And Brendan Burns, the co-founder of Kubernetes, did an interview with Stella from the Microsoft open source team about AKS and what's next for Kubernetes, and that's worth a read. The June 13th episode of Azure Friday also covers the AKS general availability news, and links to everything is in the show notes. Speaking of Kubernetes, the latest episode of the IoT Show right here on Channel 9 and our Microsoft Developer YouTube page is all about Kubernetes integration with Azure IoT Edge. And since we just covered a bunch of Kubernetes stuff, we might as well talk about containers in general, where we've got a couple of stories worth visiting. First up, Jimmy Bogard wrote a great blog post about containers and how they can be used to craft a build environment. And Jimmy's post is really focused on how containers can be used in the continuous integration part of the build environment. And this post is focused on using containers as part of a local build, but a future post, he says, will be looking at using containers in a hosted build environment. And a hosted build environment sounds a lot like a cloud, right? And cloud means Azure. Well, this is my attempt at an awkward segue to introduce Scott Hanselman's blog post on how to cheaply deploy containers to Azure. Scott even created a 21-minute video showing the entire process. Now, how cheap is cheap? Well, if you use the B1, that's the basic tier, it'll run about $33 USD a month, but you'll be able to run several containers. And of course, you can always scale up if you need more, but the goal of Scott's post was to be cheap. Over on the .NET blog, Rich Lander posted an update on using .NET and Docker together, this time timed around DockerCon 2018. And Rich's post offers a great overview of how .NET developers can try out Docker development in a container using ASP.NET and HTTPS and lots more. And Rich also has a great blog post about staying up to date with .NET container images. The .NET team pushes updates to its container images to Docker Hub multiple times a month, which ensures that every time a dev pulls a .NET image, they're getting the latest updates. And Microsoft actually maintains the .NET images, and they are built using the official images from the Docker team. And this makes it possible to offer .NET Core on multiple Linux distros, as an example. Windows Server images are also available. Anyway, this is a good post for users who are unfamiliar with the update process across .NET images. And speaking of .NET, that's a perfect segue because this week, Microsoft announced that .NET Core 2.0 will reach end of life on September 1st, 2018. Now, .NET Core 2.0 was not a long-term support release, so it gets updates just 90 days after the next .NET Core release, which was .NET Core 2.1. Now, if you haven't already upgraded to .NET Core 2.1, you need to start planning for it now. Links to migration guides for .NET Core and ASP.NET Core are in a blog post linked in the show notes. Also, for anyone curious, .NET Core 2.1 will be a long-term support release, which means it will be supported with patches for 3 years. In other .NET news, Matt Warren, and again, no relation, we actually checked, has a post on his blog about various tools you can use for exploring .NET internals. Now, most of the tools listed are single-use tools, and they're open source to boot, and that's really cool. So thank you, Matt, for this great post. Shifting from .NET a bit, kind of, the Xamarin team has a really good blog post about how to support iOS 11 and the iPhone 10 in Xamarin.iOS apps. Now, this tutorial is important because Apple has indicated that beginning in July 2018, all apps submitted to the App Store must be built with the iOS 11 SDK and support the iPhone 10's Super Retina display, and I guess the notch, too. If you've got an older Xamarin.iOS app and you want to submit updates, you'll want to make sure that you're updated and that you're building against the latest SDK. The post has a great collection of resources, so check it out. For Python fans out there, the Visual Studio blog has a guide for getting started using Microsoft's Python developer tools that are available in Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code, Azure, and more. And now it's time for my pick of the week. And since I was gone for 2 weeks, I have two picks. The first is a great history lesson from El Reg, that's the Register newspaper in London, on the 25th anniversary of the PDF, aka the portable document format. It's a really fun read, and I guess the Microsoft angle is that Office 365 is getting integrated PDF services via a new partnership with Adobe Document Cloud. But honestly, even without that news, read the history of the PDF because it's really fun, and I probably would have made this a pick anyway. But my second pick of the week is one of the coolest toy partnerships I've seen in years. The American Girl line of dolls now has an Xbox One S gaming set, which basically means that all American Girl dolls can become gamers, complete with gaming headsets, gaming chair, and an Xbox One S, plus games. I had an American Girl doll when I was little, Molly, the girl from World War II, and I used to obsess over the catalogs of tiny, very expensive accessories. What I'm trying to say is that 9-year-old me is trying to convince the me that's in my 30s to buy this. Well, that does it for me. Please be sure to like our video and subscribe to our channel for more developer content. And if you're a masochist, turn on those notifications so that you can be alerted to every time we publish out more great content. Let me know your favorite American Girl doll in the comments. See you next week.